This is Mission Control Houston. The Expedition 33 crew members on board the International Space Station kicked off the week focusing on upcoming visiting vehicle operations. Flight engineer Aki Hoshide first off activated the re-entry breakup recorder and installed it in the automated transfer vehicle number 3. During the ATV's descent through the atmosphere after its undocking on Thursday afternoon, the Reaper records data during that re-entry, records temperature and acceleration, rotational rates, and more. All of that to be transmitted and then studied to help design future spacecrafts that pose less of a hazard during re-entry. Hoshide then joined flight engineer Yuri Malenchenko for some ATV undocking training before they both went to work closing the hatches between ATV and the station. The leak checks will be conducted through the night in advance of the scheduled undocking of ATV on Tuesday afternoon at 5:35 p.m. Houston time. Hoshide also worked with Commander Sonny Williams on Monday, training for next month's arrival of the Dragon spacecraft, the commercial cargo ship that's targeted for its first operational flight to the International Space Station in early October. The Dragon now targeted to launch on October the 7th and dock to the space station on October the 10th. Crew members did some computer-based training using the Canadarm2 to grapple Dragon when it approaches the station and then berth it to the Harmony node, just as was done during the first Dragon visit to the station during its demonstration flight back in May. Williams spent time during her afternoon on maintenance in the Tranquility module. She's replacing air selector valves in the carbon dioxide removal assembly. That's a key component of the station's regenerative life support system. The CEDRA and other elements of that system maintain a healthful environment on board for the station crew members to live and to do their work. On Tuesday, the crew members will do maintenance and focus on gathering data for experiments into how the microgravity environment impacts the human body. And they will also have a midday nap built into their schedule. That's because they will be up later than usual on Tuesday afternoon to support the undocking of the ATV at 5:35 p.m. Central Time. NASA TV coverage of the departure of the European Space Agency's Eduardo Amaldi cargo vehicle begins Tuesday afternoon at 5:15 Central Time.